This is probably the most serene title music I've ever heard. Hello everyone, I'm Golden Tales Geek. Welcome to Playing Video Games for the First Time, my series of first impressions videos, in case you're wondering, if you haven't even seen the 200 some odd videos I've done in this series up to this point. First impressions entail basically games I've never played before, like most of the games on my Steam back catalog, or if there's a game that received a remake and I have played the game before, but I've never played the remake, I'll do first impressions of that as well to see how it stacks up versus the original. Although, I try to be as objective as I can, but, you know, I'm just as human as the rest of us. We all have our biases. Anyway! This week, it's another game I haven't played before that's been sitting in my Steam back catalog for quite some time. Pankapu. You can get it on Steam. It's kind of a platformer of sorts. It kind of had a very colorful art style that kind of appealed to me, and also it kind of reminded me of Prince of Persia a little bit. And I mean like the original Prince of Persia, not those 3D ones that they did and that formed the basis for the Jake Gyllenhaal movie. Speaking of Jake Gyllenhaal, he was awesome in Mysterio in Spider-Man Far From Home. Just saying. Anyway, getting that out of the way, let's just start up a new game, I guess. Oh, 4 save slots. Sweet. Okay, cool. Let's start up the game. That looks ominous.
Shaharel, are you all right? It's nothing, sweetheart. You must have had a bad dream because of the storm.
It sounded like Patrick Seitz.
I'm here. When I was little, my grandmother would often tell me a special story that would chase the nightmares away. This story takes place in the world of dreams, known as Omnia.
Interesting.
All the kingdom's inhabitants lived in harmony, filling the world with hope.
Hope's always good.
Alas, one fateful day, a horde of creatures crossed through the veil which separates this world from the Nightmare World.
Nightmare World, that's a place I wouldn't
These
want to visit.
These Hyanagi invaded Omnia, spreading their foul corruption wherever they went. The world of dreams was threatened, and with it, the hope all had once known was in danger of disappearing forever.
Well, that's not good.
Luckily, Ikutomi, the Hymn of Dreams, decided there was still time for him to act.
Well, that's good. Although, looking at him, I'm kind of reminded of Adam Warlock, but what do I know?
Using his immense powers, he concentrated all the dream matter that was left in Omnia. And birthed a guardian capable of defeating the Hyanagi invasion.
Nice armor.
His name was Pankapu.
That would explain the title of the game, I guess. And I'm glad I said it right, because I was kind of worried that I hadn't said it right. The Aegis of Bravery. Okay. Looks like a pretty kick-ass sword you got there, man. Cool. And that looks like our light meter up there in the corner there. Let's look back here real quick, because I feel like I'm missing something. Anything I'm missing? Nope, guess not. Okay. Fair enough. Alright then, let's go to Sage's Spinny. See what happens. Oh, and apparently it's one of these games where as you unlock new abilities, you can actually find new places in old levels, so that's kind of neat. There we go, good riddance to that thing. Ow! Okay, I guess I'm gonna leap over those purple things. Oh. There we go, cool. There we go, good riddance. Yay! Floating, irreceptively floating platforms. The game could be complete without them. Oop. Ah, that looks like a checkpoint. Cool. This is no lives system, because I'm kind of tired of games having lives, honestly. Hello. Filthy monster, huh? I'm not edible. Famous last words, mate. Ow! Bastard, wow. Nice try. Got him. Gee, huh? Leg, okay. Nice to meet you, Chi. Can I get back to that checkpoint and reheal? Let's see, because I would love that right now. Nope, I guess not. Oh well. Damn shame, too. Oh well. Hey, at least I rescued Chi, right, folks? I'd hate to refight that guy. He looked like a nasty piece of work. Oh! There we go, another checkpoint. Sweet! Yep. Go away, you bastard. Kinda like the music, it's kinda catchy. I got a feeling there's something might be up here later. Oh well, I'll come back later with more abilities. Anyway, let's drop down here. Let's see what we can find. Another checkpoint, sweet. Yes. Another case of irreceptibly moving platforms. Oh, shit! Guess I'm gonna have to wait till that thing goes back. Oh, okay, that didn't take long. Okay, drop down here, good. And some health. Really? There you go, get out of here, you little bastard. Sorry for cussing so much, by the way. Crossways Garden, huh? Well, it looks like there's some kind of red item and some kind of tablet in this level, so let's check it out. Okay, fine, you little globules or whatever the hell they're called. Is there like a bestiary or something I could look at here? Oh, wait. Enemies, here we go. Really? You don't count as enemies. Okay. Okay, whatever. Oh my god, that's a big fella. Well, why am I getting King Slime from Dragon vibes? Oh, it splits into two. Got the fun head tomorrow, shall take its place. This is Hydra from the MCU. There we go, cool. Thank you for your time. Hello. Mudgeons? Always check up here. Oh my. Just wouldn't be a platformer without some moving spikes of doom, wouldn't it? There we go. Okay. Getting up close and personal now. Perfect. Cool. I like how I'm kind of liking how colorful this game is, honestly. It's really fun. And also, it's just the art style of it is just really something special, too. But, whoa. Barum's dear. Alright, let's grab it. Oh, I got an achievement. Pharaoh. And it just popped up in the corner there, in addition to just popping up in the corner of my screen. It's here. A blazing ball of fire in the sky above, it is said Pharaoh is responsible for bringing light to the living. A genuine Mother Nature, she is the sun enabling life to grow wherever she goes. Moving ceaselessly across the skies, not a day goes by when her blessing is not felt. Her presence is seen in the blooming of a flower, the birth of a child, or the warmth of a sunny day. All of them being only so many manifestations of Pharum's power. And if there is one being above all others who inspires poets to write their verses, then it is she. Indeed, her heart burns with a love that never dies. However, the object of her burning passions, Sodhil, never ceases to flee her. In the dance of their eternal course across the heavens, some see the cycle of day and night, others see that it is the seasons. And still others see as the cycle of life and death. However, whatever their opinion may be on the matter, everyone agrees that the two beings shall never be reunited. It must be so for the cycle of life to go on. I like that. It actually kind of adds a little bit of mythology to the world. Makes it a little more lived in. I like that. Who knows? This may actually be based on actual folklore. I don't know, but regardless, it's pretty neat. Anyway, let's, try to leap up. Oh, shoot. Leap. Slice. There we go. Cool. I guess they counted on me getting smacked around a little bit. There we go. Alright, let's leap on that mushroom. Shame you can't level up or anything. There we go. Cool. Die! Stupid slime balls! God! There we go. Good riddance. There we go. Okay, I guess we're gonna use the Pharum's tear on that plant then.
Following his new friend's advice, Pankapu poured Pharum's tear on the bud. Imagine his surprise when the bud began to twist and grow, reaching a staggering height.
It's like Jack and the Beanstalk, sorta.
She hadn't lied. Coming across this magic spider had been a stroke of good fortune.
She did seem like a bit of a spider. I wasn't sure. Although, honestly, I initially thought that she was a scorpion, but, you know, good to know that it's a spider. What's this now? A lunatite fragment. This mystical artifact is a vessel containing life force. By collecting together four of them, you can make a complete lunatite, allowing Pankapu to increase his maximum overall HP. Okay, so it's like a heart container. Cool. Or a piece of heart, rather. Oh, hold up. There is something up here. Well, there's more of these little losers here. Let's slice them up. Slice. It slices, it dices, it pulverizes, and it makes french fries in 30 different... Whoops. The pulverizing part was my own addition there. Good riddance. Get rid of that guy. Get a little more health. Drop down here. There we go. Will you guys back off already? God. Drop down. Boom. Good riddance. Oh, sweet. I got the little fragment, too. Looks like some kind of misty thing I can get in this next level of Bravewood. You know what? Why not? We'll do one more level. Oh, wait, hold up. Apparently there's another path I could have gone. Whatever. Anyway, we'll do one more level, and then I think I'll wrap up today's video. Here we are in the Verdant Fortress. We just need to cross it to get to... I missed what the last bit was, but... Like, apparently we need to cross the Verdant Forest in order to get to a certain little area that's important. So. Oh joy, more temporarily disappearing platforms. Just what I need. Slice, slice, slice. Slice. There we go. Leap on over! Ow. Oh, you again, huh? I should start calling these things King Slimes. I really should. Oh well. See you later. I have a feeling that was a secret passage I was just in. Can you hear weeping? I think so, yeah. Yeah, let's go check it out indeed. Gee, I'm with you. Oh, hello. OT. Ohidi. Sorry, I said it wrong. Poor fella. Mio's shard, huh? Ready. Well, good thing there's a checkpoint right here, so that should be a godsend. That's a bit of a godsend. Hello, hold up. Actually, I want to see this red crystal here right quick, because I'm intrigued. Oh, okay. Apparently I'm not strong enough to crack that thing yet. Oh, well. Guess this is a case of me remembering that for later. God damn. Such a pity I can't kill those things. Glimmering row for next time, huh? Well, I guess I'm gonna call it a day here. It's been about 20 minutes, which is a nice good amount of time to do a game like this, really, when you're doing a first impressions video, I find. In fact, this series was actually inspired by Stephen George's first 20 series, so it's funny how that works out. Anyway, till my next video, whether it's a Let's Play, a playing video games for the first time video like this, video game boss fight video, or any other thing I decide to put on my channel, keep on gaming, be awesome to one another. Oh! And before I go, I'll put a link in the video description so you guys can check out the game on Steam for yourself. I actually got it pretty cheap on a sale, but if you want to pay full price, I wouldn't judge it. Anyway, see you later, folks. Bye! Also, I have to say, before I go, this music is also just as serene as the title music. It's just something calming about that. See ya. Sorry.